I time to last for a lifetime. That's all I know now.
Hey, Charles, we're recording this video right now and you're singing. Is that the song you want for this week?
I'll put it on Chassie's computer. Yeah.
Okay, how about we just get started? We won't have music today. Is that good? Mm. All right, I'll play something real quick.
The Crying Sun, I think. That's what it's called. The Crying Moon.
No.
No. What you doing? I'm going to punch the crust off the lid.
Guys, we're recording. All right. Good morning and happy Monday. How's it going over there?
Good.
Good.
Hey, Ms. Malkinoff, can I be in the morning meeting?
Sure, Charles. Chassie, why don't you introduce your brother to us?
So his name is Charles Benjamin Gibson III. And yeah.
My birthday is September 13th, 2013.
What grade are you in and who's your teacher, Charles?
My teacher, Miss Monge, I'm in 10th grade.
Second grade.
Oh, in second grade. I forgot what they call it, but second
shout out to Miss Mellinger. She's got to work on making sure you know what grade you're in. Well, let's get started on this morning meeting. We're going to start by taking a look at our morning meeting PowerPoint. Today is Monday, March 22nd, 2021. And I don't know if you guys know, but this is our last morning meeting until after spring break. Isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
We just got back and we're about to go on spring break.
Yeah.
All right. And today is the day that third through eighth graders start coming back to school. So we are excited to welcome back our third through eighth graders. Chassie, you're finally here in the building with us. We're so excited. Charles has been here already for a week now. But our third through eighth graders start today. Cohort A starts today. So we're excited to have you. Welcome back.
Yeah,
thank you.
And go over the schedule for coming back to school. So if you were a phase one kid, you were in Miss Hatcher, Miss Albrecht, Miss Saul, Miss Carr, Miss Leisinger's class, you guys have been here already. And if you're pre-K to two, like Charles, you've been in school already a week. This week starts everyone in phase three, which is, like I said, is grade three through eight. There are two groups for every grade level. There's A and B. Students who are in A group come on Monday and Tuesdays, and students who are in B group come on Thursdays and Friday. Chastity and Charles, are you A or B?
What? I wasn't paying attention.
No, I'm A, because I come on Monday and Tuesdays.
Perfect. You're both A's. All right.
Now, I know this is
Women's History Month. This is our final morning meeting for the month of March. This week, we will continue to focus on women who have contributed to our world.
Awesome.
Some women's history. When U.S. women are given the right to vote in 1920, it only allowed white women to vote. You also had to be able to read in order to vote. And I can see.
And all women were not officially allowed to vote until 1965. That's crazy.
And the state of Wyoming, that was a territory, and 1924 was the first area to give the women a right to vote. Women were not allowed to have their own credit cards until 1974. What? Aretha Franklin was the first woman featured in the
Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Dang, I'm happy I'm a man.
Yeah. Who, you want to play the Who Am I game?
Yeah. Charles, are you in?
Yeah.
See if we can figure it out.
Who am I? I was born in Kansas on July 24th,
1897. Dang, you're old.
I was a female pilot. I was the 16th woman to get a pilot's license. I studied at Columbia University. I had a goal to be the first woman to fly in a circle around the world. I disappeared on July 2nd, 1937, and was never seen again. Who am I?
Ooh. I wonder who she is.
Today, we're going to be learning about Amelia Earhart. This presentation is about Amelia Earhart by Chastity Gibson. Amelia Earhart. Amelia Mary Earhart was an American pilot and author. Earhart was the first female pilot to fly by herself across the Atlantic Ocean. She set many other records, wrote best-selling books about her flying experience, and helped to create the 99s, an organization for female pilots. Amelia Earhart childhood. Amelia Earhart was born on July 24th, 1897 in Atchison, Kansas. Her father, Edwin, was a lawyer who worked for the railroad. She spent a lot of her childhood playing with her younger sister, Marielle. When they were playing, Amelia liked to crash and tell her sister that it was just like fun. Amelia Earhart marriage. George Palmer Putnam was an American publisher, author, and explorer. He became Amelia Earhart's husband and was famous for being a successful promoter in the United States during the 1930s. Amelia Earhart kids. Amelia didn't have any children of her own, but she did have two stepkids. Amelia Earhart disappearance. Amelia Earhart set a goal to be the first woman to fly around the entire world. She left for the trip on June 1st, 1937. Her plane disappeared on July 2nd, 1937, and she was never seen again.
She disappeared?
Five fun facts about Amelia Earhart. Number one, Amelia saw her first plane at the State Fair when she was 10 years old. Two, during the World War I, she was a nurse and helped wounded soldiers. Three, on December 28, 1920, a pilot Frank Hawk gave Amelia her first ride in an airplane. Four, Amelia took her first flying lesson on January 3rd, 1921. Five, while living in Boston, she wrote articles.
Wow, thanks for sharing that, Chastity.
You're welcome.
So who do that step away?
What should we do now, guys? What do you think, Charles?
Why are you on mute?
Mm-hmm. What you say?
What do you think we should do now, Charles?
Watch this video.
Watch this
Let's
video.
Let's watch a video.
Let's watch a video. All right, guys, what'd you think?
It was good.
It was good. Charles, I am wondering, what do you think was the message of that video? What was it trying to tell us?
It was trying to tell us that you need love in your life. Because if you don't have love, you'll be sad.
you'll be sad and you'll be pretty lonely. And I also think it a little bit connects to us at Mary Bethune, because we've all been like our little lonely volcanoes all by ourselves for a really long time now. And finally we're together again. So that's why I thought it was a good video for us. I'm glad you liked it. All right. Thank you again, Charles, for sharing that message. And I'm hoping all of our scholars will take some time with their teacher today and talk about what they think the message is of this video, and if it's any different than what Charles and I think. Okay, I want to just follow up with a couple other reminders. I know some people are asking, should I be in school? I'm not there, not yet at least. But I want to remind everyone a couple things. Everyone's on their own schedule. So if you're not here today, it's not a big deal. Some students are not even going to start until this Thursday for the first time. So don't worry, you have to follow your own schedule. And again, if you're a scholar that's staying remote and are just going to be online and won't be coming back to the building, don't worry, we're still here for you. You're still a Bethune scholar. We still love you. You're still going to get to see our meeting every week. I had a concern Chastity actually brought up to me, and she asked me some questions about busing. So I know there have been about busing, and I wanted to make sure that I answered those questions. If you or your family is having any issues with your bus route, or you have questions about your bus, please, you have two options. You can call 838, the number 4, and the word bus to get some help from the transportation department. Or you can call us at the school. Mrs. Goggins will help you at 838-2250. So don't be frustrated about busing. We have some people who can help you. Also, we've said it before, if you have any questions about remote or hybrid learning, parents can call the school at 838-2250 or check out the website clevelandmetroschools.org/hybrid. The same goes for students as well. We are all here to help you figure things out while we get used to this new learning.
That's all for this video.
That's all we have for this week. And we won't see you next week because it's spring break, but we will see you back after that. So we are excited to see you after spring break. Charles, you have any messages for our students and staff this week?
Charles? Doing amazing things this week.
Do amazing things this week. Awesome. I love it. Well, thanks, Chassie, for all your hard work. I think that Chassie's doing such an amazing job. She's going to be staying on and working on some more of these projects with us. What do you think, Chastity?
What do I think about what?
Staying on and helping out in the future for our morning meetings.
Sounds good.
All right. You think we'll see Charles again on our morning meetings?
Yeah.
All right. Well, have a great weekend. Charles, you want to sing us out or you want me to put that song back on? All right. Well, I'm going to end us with a song, and everyone have a great week. You are such a big idea, that's your mama, right?